Hello and welcome to Work in Progress Japan. I'm Alex, and today I'll be taking you on a deep dive into Japanese culture and society. For this first episode, we're in Ebisu, a stylish district southwest of central Tokyo. I'll be talking to business owner and tea master, Ryo Iwamoto.
While tea has been a staple of Japanese culture since the 8th century, the practice of drinking tea ceremonially at Buddhist monasteries was imported from China in the 12th century. From there, the way of tea, known in Japanese as either chado or sado, developed over time. It became widespread throughout Japan in the 16th century, thanks to Buddhist scholar and tea master Sen Norikyu. After the death of Sen Norikyu in 1591, chado split into three distinct schools that still practice to this day. Ryo is a master of the largest of these three schools, Urasenke. Twenty-three-year-old Ryo Iwamoto is the founder of Tearoom, a company that provides tea consulting services to major companies in Japan. He's been practicing chado for 14 years. Why did you start practicing chado at such a young age? What made you decide this would become your career? How long can you sit on your knees like that? What does your typical day look like? Ryo has a busy schedule today. After taking care of a few personal errands, we're off to his first meeting in Suidobashi. After a 30-minute trip, we arrive at our destination, the Iwashi Club Shisha Bar.
How much time in the day would you say that you spend on like social media and marketing activities?
So,
my first time trying tea flavored shisha. It's it surprisingly tastes like tea. I wasn't expecting the tea flavor to really come through, but it really does, and it's good.
After the meeting, it's time to head back to the office, and I'm starving.
What are we doing for lunch? You're not eating at all. Just tea?
That reminded me of something Ryo had said earlier. As soon as we got back to the office, Ryo had to prepare for his evening event. While Ryo was busy with preparations, we took some time to look around his office.
So, this place has a tatami room. Ryo has tatami shoes, and he also has a tatami chair. So I guess a real tea master has to be in contact with tatami at all times. This is the kitchen part of Ryo's office. And honestly, I have no idea what's going on. He's got a ton of cups, from all different shapes and sizes. He's got these little brushes here for the matcha tea. He's got some kind of tea preparation sitting in a frying pan, and a whole lot of mesmer here.
As preparations for the event were still underway, Ryo took a virtual meeting with potential clients from the US.
Our next stop is going to be Kuramae, where Ryo will be participating in an event hosted by a club over there. As you can see right now, they're really busy getting ready for this event. We've made it to the Nui Bar and Hostel in Kuramae. This is where the event is supposed to take place tonight. Ryo is expecting about 120 people, and he's already inside making preparations, so let's go. Can you tell me a bit about what to expect at the event tonight?
PM sharp, the event begins. Ryo will spend the next 4 hours serving tea and mingling with his guests.
I managed to get my hands on some of Ryo's tea. It's really good, it's really interesting.
Let's go check on how Ryo's doing.
It's only been 30 minutes, you have 3.5 hours. So, the event is underway and Ryo is busy. Let's go ask some other people what they think about Ryo's work.
それだけだと一般のお客様というか普通の人たちに届かないので、多分それを岩本さんが ジンとジンとお茶をつなげて、でお茶と茶道をつなげて、でその精神性とか豊かな精神性みたいなものを広げていってくるのに寄与するんじゃないかなと思います。
After 4 hours, the event finally started winding down. While a lot of the customers had left, Ryo and his team were planning on staying well into the night and spending the night at Nui. We went and asked Ryo for his final thoughts on the evening.
When I was told that I was going to follow the tea master for a whole day, this is not at all what I had in mind. Do you think that this is what the future is going to look like for people in your profession?
そうですね。お茶のマスターっていう人、もちろん文化側で、文化の世界で突き詰めていくっていうのが一つあると思うんですけど、日本茶ってものにまず着目をしたときに、まだまだその飲料だけではない可能性っていうのがまだあると思うんです。それはタバコに今日朝したようにタバコにしたり、水タバコっていう形にしたり、それこそジンと酒にしたり、いろんな方法で日本茶ってものを見つめていけば、おそらく僕らの方に市場は流れていくんじゃないかなと思います。
What for you is like the essence of chatter? What is the most important element of this practice?
そうですね。私たちは向き合うって体験っていうところが本質だと思っていて、例えば自分に向き合う内省、セルフメディケーションとか内省だし、人に向き合うコミュニケーション、おもてなしみたいなものがあるわけですよ。向き合うって体験をさせるっていうのが茶道ってものの特徴で、それこそお茶を立てることによって、自分と向き合う、物と向き合う、人と向き合うって行為をさせるっていうのが、すごいいい行為だなっていうふうに思って、ちょっと補足で話すと、日本茶を消費する、日本茶を飲むって体験自体も、その向き合うって体験ができるわけじゃないですか。自分で時間を作って自分の体調を知るようにしたり、そういった日本茶の体験に茶道のエッセンスを入れていくってことで、そのお茶のいいところっていうのを味わえるかなっていうふうに思ってますね。
Do you think you're going to keep doing this job until retirement?
そうですね。一応我々の会社の事業計画自体は40年っていうふうに引いてるんですが、40年かけて市場全部取る、またその文化と産業っていうのを再興していくっていうのを目指しているので、40年くらい頑張ってやれたらいいなと思いますね。今はただちょっと忙しすぎかなっていう。
Thank you, Ryo, and good luck.
I think from what we saw today, there's still a strong culture of tea here in Japan. Overall, throughout the country, there's still about 2 million people who practice chado. And practitioners like Ryo were trying to breathe a new life into the movement. It still feels like chado has some bright days ahead. I think the thing that struck me the most is that chado isn't really about the 4-hour preparation or all of the complicated movements or all of the instruments and things like that. It's more about taking a break from everyday life, being able to rest, being able to disconnect from everything else that's going on and focus on the moment. I really admire how Ryo was able to take his passion, this thing that he's been doing since he was 9 years old, and turn it into a profession that brings him joy and fulfillment. And after such a long day following his work, I think I could really use a break too. So I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for watching the first episode of Work in Progress Japan. Let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. If you like this episode, make sure you click the like button. If you want to see more episodes like this, be sure to subscribe. You can also find links to our social media and our other content in the description down below. See you next time.